What is up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Guns, Nerds, and Steel. Alpha 20 has just been released, but there is already increasing buzz regarding the next installment in 7 Days to Die, Alpha 21. This video is not intended to be an official preview since the formal roadmap has not yet been released. Instead, I will be discussing some features that were initially intended for Alpha 20 but were delayed, and I will show you some things that have been discussed on the forums and things that I found hints for in the game files as well. Timestamps below if you'd like to jump ahead, but otherwise, let's begin. Hidden inside the quest.xml game file, there is a teaser for Tier 6 missions and therefore Tier 6 quest rewards. It seems hard to imagine a POI larger than the current Tier 5s, which include the Higashi Tower, Dashong Tower, and the factories, but indeed the framework has been laid out for even bigger and more dangerous quests in the future. Who knows if this will be implemented, but it's fun to imagine massive, complex facilities as the setting for ultra-difficult but ultra-rewarding missions. My idea of what a Tier 6 POI would look like is essentially an entire city tile of some particular theme, such as an airport, nuclear facility, shopping mall, or military base, each with multiple buildings of various sizes, underground portions, and epic boss fights at the end. Share your ideas for Tier 6 quest locations in the comments below. Tucked away in the progression.xml file is reference to a flamethrower perk within the Fortitude tree, which would presumably be accompanied by a flamethrower weapon. The perk has 5 levels like the other weapon perks, and there may be some other items related to this, which we'll get into later. Another item within the items.xml file is a throwable flare. It's not clear what the function of this would be, but presumably it will act as a throwable light source at the very least. Seeing this makes me really wish there was also a flashbang grenade that could temporarily stun zombies. Speaking of stun, a new Tier 3 baton appears to be planned according to the items.xml file. The plasma baton appears to be just a buffed up version of the Tier 2 stun baton, and it will benefit from the electrocutioner perk tree as well. Removed in Alpha 17, but still found within the game files, the gas mask could be resurrected for Alpha 21. It would provide elemental protection against radioactive and toxic environments, but not as much as the hazmat mask at this time. And this brings us to the next topic. Previously, the burned biome and the wasteland biome were set to be combined and undergo a major facelift, but Alpha 20 came and no significant change was observed other than the removal of the burned biome from random world gen. In developer livestreams, it was mentioned that you would receive an environmental debuff while in the wasteland, and you would need to wear appropriate protective clothing like the hazmat suit or take anti-radiation medication in order to survive long periods of time there. I would hope to see these changes come about in Alpha 21. The robotic drone weapon mod was originally slated for release along with the robotic drone itself, but ultimately this was delayed. It's unclear why, and it's also unclear if the Fun Pimps intend to refine this for release in Alpha 21, but the mod does exist within the Alpha 20 game files. There are some lines in the game files that mention new mods and schematics. Some have been around for several alphas now, but the fact that they haven't been removed suggests that they may have some utility in a future update. An armor mod You're Fired, which increases fire resistance, an armor mod Radiation Ready, which provides radiation protection, a melee mod Nickel-Cadmium Battery, which changes damage type to electricity, a melee mod Flammable Oil, which changes damage type to heat, a melee mod Liquid Nitrogen, which changes damage type to cold, and a weapon mod Blessed Metal, which doubles damage to evil or undead, basically the opposite of the Hunter mod. Bandits are set to be the prime feature of Alpha 21, and they've been planning this since at least Alpha 12. Bandits will be non-player characters that you can interact with in the world, and by interact, I mean kill and loot, but maybe talk to. But probably mostly just kill and loot. One of the reasons I say this is because they're referred to in the entityclasses.xml file as enemy animals. Bandits will drop some kind of loot container with bandit-specific loot, and bandits will come in 3 varieties: melee, ranged, and leader. There are some reports on the forums that the Fun Pimps are planning for new boss zombies, but it's unclear which direction they are going in. They seem to have made bandits the top priority, but what kind of boss zombies would you like to see in the game? Previously we had the Behemoth, but it was eventually removed in Alpha 16 with planned reintroduction later on, which has yet to happen. currently the only boss zombie is the Demolisher. Current armor is set to be replaced with thematic outfits that work like books. Wearing a complete set will unlock a special completion perk. Be warned that this concept art is over 1 year old at this point, and it's still likely a major work in progress, but we do have confirmation that the Fun Pimps are currently working on this overhaul. The current 10-slot system will be reduced to 4 slots, which will merge clothing and armor values. There will be better balance on the number of mod slots available for use. Some examples of how this works are the Nerd Shoes, which appear to confer a similar advantage to the current Impact Bracing mod, the Nerd Goggles, which are like the Nerdy Glasses, the Nomad Outfit Bonus, which gives a bartering bonus similar to that of the current Cigar, and the Scavenger Outfit Bonus, which gives a better loot stage, much like the Lucky Goggles. In my experience, this has been one of the most controversial changes that have been announced so far. But this change is coming whether we like it or not. However, Alpha 21 is a long way away. So instead of grieving in the comments section, I encourage you to let everyone know what changes you would like to see in order to make this more appealing. More info on the water overhaul is yet to come, but it does appear that the Fun Pimps wish to make the waterfront a more integral aspect of the game. There have been mentions of water-based vehicles, waterlogged zombies, and even aquatic animals during previous developer livestreams, but no solid word on any of this just yet. For the most part, I believe their goal is to simply make water less buggy and a bit more realistic. There is a planned story mode, which has been alluded to for quite a while now. If you've ever read that note in your hotbar when you spawn in, you'll realize that there's more to Nava's game than meets the eye. There is a duke, some kind of leader, of the post-apocalyptic civilization that you are a part of. Even the traders sometimes hint towards his presence.
The duke is blocking all shipments until that job is done.
Certainly the goal for gold will be to have a fully finished story mode, but there are rumblings that this could begin with Alpha 21. Nava's game will be updated with all of the new POIs in Alpha 21 and will be the setting for this new feature. Zombies are said to be able to deliberately crawl through 1-meter gaps in addition to the 1.5 meter gaps which began in Alpha 20. There will also be wandering zombies within POIs in addition to the sleepers, which should give a little bit more life or death to indoor exploration. The Hawaiian zombie is said to be getting some kind of a gas attack, a special ability along the lines of what we see from the cop and mutated zombies. The interesting random event manager feature has been mentioned on and off on the 7 Days to Die forums. Essentially, this feature will spawn encounter scenarios on your projected path. Examples might include something like a bandit ambush while you are on your way back to the trader, carrying the supply chest from a buried supplies quest, or a courier satchel from a fetch quest, or dynamic hordes of zombies, among others. Traders in Alpha 21 will have a scaled inventory based on your game stage. This is intended to essentially limit your access to late game items early on and prevent you from accessing end game items via the secret stash by simply leveling up in one perk, better barter. According to a developer's comments on the forum, quote, "We might have to completely rebalance weapon parts for 21 because of the new crafting system I'm working on. The system will make crafting more granular, so you can craft many ranges of weapons. Crafting a blue pipe shotgun at skill 25 or so lets you craft a brown double barrel shotgun at that level. Even an increase of 1 will allow you to potentially craft a little bit better weapon. So I can see players frequently recrafting weapons in the long game to get the micro improvements as their skill goes up." He goes on to say, quote, "Nothing is finalized, but we're talking about a crafting skill for every item in the game. Associated books and schematics might add to it when read, and probably the introduction of technical journals or something you find and can read to add to the skill. Something we can control and loot, so players don't get too powerful too soon. No spam crafting, and skill system to where it's easier to craft a blue stone axe than a blue steel axe." It sounds to me like this overhaul is still very early in development, but it seems as though they want to make the crafting system a bit more complicated and rewarding, especially late game. I'd say we have at least a year to explore Alpha 20 before we get our hands on Alpha 21, but here's my pitch to you. Subscribe to my channel and become a nerd of steel, and I'll continue to bring to you updates on Alpha 20, Alpha 21, gold releases of the game, as well as Let's Plays, tips and tricks, tutorials, live streams, and base builds. But until then, I wish you all the very best. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. While you're waiting for the next video, check out the links below for more content, ways to support the channel, and ways to join the ranks of the Nerds of Steel. You can catch me on the Discord, Twitter, at the weekly livestream, or in the comment section down below. Huge thank you to all of my supporters who help grow and shape this channel. My name is Tamriki, and I hope that I've earned your subscription today. I'll see you next time.